Hi, this is Dr. A. In this medical terminology video, we are going to look at the signs and symptoms and pathologies that are associated with blood. All right, let's start with the signs and symptoms. So coagulate is to convert a liquid to a solid, as in blood clotting. Milk can also coagulate when it goes bad and gets chunky. Dyscrasia is a general term for a disease affecting blood. Hematoma is a collection of blood under the skin as a result of blood escaping into tissue from damaged blood vessels. It's also like a bruise. Basically, a bruise is a hematoma. Hemorrhage is blood flowing out of a vessel. It usually indicates like maybe a bigger quantity. Thrombus is a hard collection of fibrin, blood cells, and tissue debris that is the result of a blood clotting process. So a thrombus is a blood clot. So here is an electron micrograph that shows a blood clot. So we have fibrin in white, the red blood cells here in red, and tissue debris around there. Hemophilia. So this is our first blood pathology term. Hemophilia is a genetic disorder in which blood fails to clot due to a lack of one clotting factor. Hyperlipidemia is an excessive level of lipids in the bloodstream. So hyper is excessive, lipid is fats or lipids, and emia is in the blood. And this is a risk factor for atherosclerosis, which is the building up of plaque in the blood vessels, especially the arteries. Pancytopenia means having too few of all the blood cells. So pan is all, cyto is cells, penia is too few. Septicemia is having bacteria or their toxins in the bloodstream. It is also called blood poisoning, or sometimes we refer to a patient being septic. Anemia is a group of conditions that are characterized by a reduction in the number of red cells or the amount of hemoglobin, and this results in less oxygen being transported and reaching tissues. Aplastic anemia is a severe anemia where the bone marrow stops making enough red cells and white cells, and it may require a bone marrow transplant. Erythrocytosis is a condition of having too many red cells, and erythropenia is a condition of having too few red cells. A hemolytic anemia is an anemia, so a lack of red cells and or hemoglobin, but this one, it results from the destruction of red cells. So that's what the hemolysis is, hemoblyosis, destruction or rupturing of the blood cells. A hemolytic reaction is the destruction of the red cells when a patient receives an incompatible blood transfusion. So if you refer back to the anatomy and physiology of blood video, we talk about blood types. And for example, if a type A blood got type B blood, you would get a hemolytic reaction, which can be deadly. Hypochromic anemia is an anemia that results from the insufficient amount of hemoglobin in red cells. So the red cells just don't have enough hemoglobin in each red cell. And so the red cells are unable to transport enough oxygen. And it, because of that, you know, the hemoglobin gives it its color, its red color. And so if there's not enough in it, the red cells look pale. So they're hypo, low chromic color. So they have low color, they look pale. An iron deficiency anemia is an anemia that results from an insufficient amount of iron to make the hemoglobin for the red cells. And incidentally, that's a anemia that would be a hypochromic anemia, because if you don't have enough iron, you don't have enough hemoglobin. If you don't have enough hemoglobin, your cells will look pale or hypochromic. Pernicious anemia is due to an insufficient absorption of vitamin B12, and because of that, then you are unable to make enough red cells, because vitamin B12 is needed for copying cells, making more cells, copying DNA and other things like that. So anyway, we need vitamin B12 to make red cells. If you don't have enough, that could be due to pernicious anemia. Polycythemia vera is a condition of having too many red cells. The blood is too thick and flows sluggishly. So you have too many red cells. There are various conditions that can cause polycythemia vera. Sickle cell anemia is a genetic disorder where the red cells take on abnormal sickle cell shape. It becomes more fragile and it leads to a hemolytic anemia. So that when the red cells sickle, they get stuck in the circulation, they become more fragile, and then they rupture. And when a person has a crisis, a lot of that happens at the same time, and it can cause pain, and it can cause a lack of oxygenation to tissue. Thalassemia is a genetic disorder in which the body is unable to produce functioning hemoglobin or to produce enough functioning hemoglobin, and so they have a decrease in hemoglobin production. They usually can produce some, obviously, otherwise, some of those, if it's a really bad one, the baby doesn't live, but there are some where they simply produce a decreased amount. All right, so here is a normal red cell, and this is a sickle red cell, sickle shape. So this is what the cells would look like in a sickle cell patient after they've had a sickle cell crisis. Leukemia is a cancer of the white cell, and this is the white cell forming portion of the red bone marrow. And so it results in a large number of abnormal and immature white cells that circulate in the bloodstream. And so this is different from a leukocytosis. So this is a cancer, and it originates in the bone marrow. So a leukocytosis is simply a condition of having too many white blood cells. When the body is fighting off an infection, especially if it's a bacterial infection, the amount of white cells will go up in response to that infection. And so that is a leukocytosis. A leukemia is increase of like abnormal white cells, and it's usually way beyond what you would see in a leukocytosis. Leukopenia is a condition of having too few white cells, and so a decreased amount. This could be due to a chemotherapy that has wiped out the leukemia cells, and then you end up with leukopenia, not enough white cells, but certain viral infections can cause leukopenia also. Lymphocytic leukemia is a type of leukemia in which the abnormal white cells are lymphocytes, so you have an increased amount of those lymphocytes. And a myeloid leukemia is a type of leukemia in which the abnormal white cells are the granulocytes. So it could be the neutrophil line or the eosinophil line or the basophil line or mix. And then thrombocytopenia is a condition of having too few platelets. And thrombocytosis is a condition of having too many platelets. And so neither one are too good, because usually when you have too many, they're not really functioning correctly also. And so that's going to wrap up our pathology and our signs and symptoms for blood.